guys, today I'm making another video. This pickle could still be on my, so I'm just gonna keep it right here. Ooh, pickle juice.
Your touchdown to Mohamed Sanu put you guys up for good. What did you see on that play?
Yeah, just had a lot of time in the pocket, so credit to our offensive line scrambling. I just have so much trust in our guys and Mo in the back of the end zone.
I'm taking another bite.
Make a play, and I didn't see it. I just kind of threw it, and then I heard the crowd, so it was good.
Snap the losing streak. What does that mean to you guys?
We're one step closer. We just gotta, get back to it and try and find another way to get a win next week.
All right, thanks, Matt. Congrats.
Behind you.
On the road, playing against Saint. Very hot.
Once upon a time. This is the darkest, so I'm just gonna kick him in the butt.
33-10 is your final weather now, with 19 touchdowns on the year, and the Eagles having won 6 straight. 33-10, Eagles beat 49.
I don't think you guys know.
Alright, partner, today, you faced a great defensive front. Now, they got to you early, but you overcame that. What was it like?
One day.
Obviously, we just started off slow.
Wow. The pickle is cursed. Soon, the boy bit it.
There's a lot of things we got to clean up, but we're excited to come out of the way.
I tell you, Howie, Jason Peters is a big
loss. Like the butt something?
But the Eagles are playing so well right now. We're just looking for reasons to go, what's going wrong right now?
They did what they were supposed to do today, and as Carson mentioned, they started slow with the defense.
The boy thought it was safe, but his heart hurt.
Opportunistic, always around the football, great pressure from the defensive front. Rams, you name it, they're always around the football.
But he killed him.
Tip balls, their secondary really rallies to the ball. Great reception here, runs it back for a touchdown. Nice
return. What?
Back against the
and I turned it off.
Took care of business today, but really, I think we're coming down to it. We're talking Dallas.
Dang it, my flashlight. Okay, this is the last bit of pickle.
If Dallas can keep pace, they've got 2 games with Philadelphia. Nope, that's the matchup that I think we're all looking
for. Sounds like you're not sold that Philadelphia is the best team in football.
Just there.
I'm trying not to be a homer.
I'm just gonna say the pickle just won one more.
Looking at Philadelphia today, going against the 49ers, that won the game, won a game all year.
Well, let's think of it like that, though.
Carson Wentz was under a lot of pressure early. He was sacked 3 times. He was forcing some throws. And I do think that they're gonna miss him down the road when they play against some better teams. But as of now, we look at the record way the offense and the defense are playing well together.
This was my flashlight.
They are the best team in the league. They're the one team that's consistent. And they're the team that we haven't looked up and said, how did they lose that game?
Complete.
Yeah, they've been complete the entire season. So for now, absolutely. But as the season goes, some of these teams have struggled. They're going to get their footing. They're going to become consistent. And then we'll see.
Yeah, I agree with you right there. Right now, they're the most complete team. Offense, defense, special teams, coaching, everything seems to be hitting off all cylinders week in and week out. Carson Wentz, we had the conversation in the pregame show. Is he the best quarterback in the NFL right now? I know they're going to miss Jason Peters, but just week in and week out, he just seems like he's making such great decisions. I think Tom Brady obviously would have something to say about that. But Carson Wentz, he's got my vote for the second best quarterback in the NFL right now.
Well, they're fighting through the Peters injury right now, but they've been fighting through injuries since week 1. Yeah, it seems like every week someone goes down.
I'm just going to drink the pickle juice already. I'm going to drink it already.
Carolina desperately trying to get a victory. Offensively, the Hawks struggled all year. Cam Newton finally killed him. Benji doing a nice job by Benjamin Blewett for 25-yard touchdown. Cam Newton led this team in rushing 17-3.
I'm already done with my pickle.
They gave up only 3 points in losing last week in Chicago, only 3 points in victory today against the Buccaneers. Luke Kuechly after the game, the door open.
5-3 at the halfway point. You are right in the thick of this NFC South race now. The most important thing this team needs to do as you go forward.
They've got to be consistent. And, we got a lot of good teams coming up. And the biggest thing in the NFL is to be consistent. And, we've been good in spots this year, but we haven't been as consistent as we needed to be. And And hopefully we can take some momentum forward and keep going.
I did not see you stop smiling this entire game. How happy are you to be back?
Oh, it's good to be back out here. And we got a lot of good guys on our team. They're fun to play with. I think the two corners did, in three corners, Daryl, Kevon, and James did an excellent job at them. I don't know how many yards they ended up having, but this is a really good passing offense, and those guys did a great job, and Mike and Jairus and Kurt played good, too. So it was a fun game, and hopefully we keep it going.
So great seeing you. Thanks so much, and congratulations on the win.
Thank you.
Mike Kuechly obviously back from that concussion after he spoke more open. He went inside the locker room and...
One more DZ? Hey, guys, I got something in my hand. Wonder what it is? DZ. Where are they? Environment. I can only take two every day. I mean, two every day. And then this is not three.
There's our commissioner, Roger Goodell. Case Keenum, backup quarterback, Sam Bradford out with that injured knee right now. Keenum finding Kyle Rudolph tied in on a quick close. 4 yards and 33-16. Vikings in pleasure. Vikings have now won five straight games.
Okay, Keenum, boom.
Rolling over the Rangers by 20. The Chargers go into New England where the Patriots take care of business. They're quiet, 6-2 New England is. And Indianapolis and Cincinnati play the Goodwin Bengals.
Why didn't you look at me? Trigger Winky.
Don't forget, after the OT tonight, you'll be game five of the World Series as well. Justin Turner and...
Since
the series is all even at two games apiece.
Introducing the Boeing 737 MAX 8. More fuel efficient, less noise, same low fares. That's transparency.
Whether you trust the Fox 4 WAP, free at the App Store. Today's Cowboys game on Fox 4.
Guardian!
Take the wheel.
If you can snap a photo, you can sell your car yourself. Blinker, take the wheel.
That was Slimmy Jubby Paper Edition. It's just... No, it's a bad end, it's a bad end.
To anticipate...
Watch this. I like those little swing animations. Okay.